Well, all the services at the Princess Margaret Hospital could possibly be back online as early as tomorrow. This after alleged sabotage to chilling units at the hospital led to a temporary suspension of non-emergency procedures. The health minister gave our Antoinette Smith this update.
A solution is on the way. After alleged sabotage of chilling and air conditioning units at the critical care block of the Princess Margaret Hospital left all elective surgical operations temporarily suspended. Now Minister of Health, the Honorable Dr. Dwayne Sands, says operations could be back on stream as early as Tuesday, as he anticipates a temporary chiller unit en route to PMH will correct the cooling problems.
Our teams are in the process of clearing it at customs. Once that process is done and all appropriate fees paid, that unit will be transported to the campus of the Princess Margaret Hospital. It will subsequently be wired into and connected into the existing air conditioning system.
The health minister said the hospital's critical care block would have experienced issues with the cooling system in the past. And while the 250-ton unit is a temporary solution, Dr. Sands says a permanent fix will take an additional 2 units, another $1.2 million, and a 4 to 5 month wait.
Now find ourselves having replaced one of the 4 chillers to replace an additional 2 chillers. At a total cost of just shy in total of $2 million. That type of investment over such a compressed period of time, such a short period of time, is not sustainable. And it adds tremendously to the cost of delivering healthcare.
And while there has been speculation and backlash on whether the 4 chiller units in question have indeed been tampered with, Minister Sands says the hospital would not have revealed these claims without evidence.
The public can be assured that we would neither be that reckless or that capricious to release a statement unless we had compelling information that would lead us to make such a statement.
The Royal Bahamas Police Force is expected to launch a thorough investigation into the matter to ensure those who allegedly tampered with the units are held accountable. And while the wait is on for a permanent resolution, Minister Sands says he applauds the surgical teams for their efforts under such difficult conditions. Antoinette Smith for ZNS Network News.